Hello, my name is Kurt. I'm a senior principal engineer working with the Dell GSE support team. This video will be demonstrating how to configure a Microsoft HCI hyper-converged network using QLogic network adapters, as defined in the Dell reference guide, Network Integration and Host Network Configuration Options Deployment Guide. This guide is referenced in the Microsoft HCI Solutions from Dell Technologies Deployment Guide. HCI hyperconverged networks channel all management and storage network communication over the same network hardware components. Our demo coming up will include the configuration of a switch-enabled team based on two QLogic 25 gigabit Fastlink adapters. Three virtual network adapters will be created, one for our host public management network and two for our storage RDMA network communication. We're doing the configuration using a PowerShell script taken from the deployment guide mentioned at the beginning of our video. When using the downloaded PDF version of that guide, this configuration information can be found in pages 7 through 9. Let's go ahead and take a look at our script. The first portion of the script creates variables that are referenced later in the script. This variable information is based on the deployment environment and naming preferences of the organization. Items like the VM switch name, virtual adapter names, IP information, VLAN tagging information need to be defined in the variable section of the script for both the management and storage networks. Once all the variable information has been declared, script processing begins creating and configuring objects making up the converged network. The new team is configured, the management network adapter is created, and the network IP and VLAN information is being assigned to the newly created adapter. The last section of the script creates and configures the storage networking. Two virtual adapters are created, IP information and VLAN information is assigned to the new networks. Keep in mind, all the network traffic will be running over the three virtual adapters on the two QLogic adapters in the set team. Once again, this script example is found in the deployment guide highlighted at the beginning of the video. I've plugged in the IP values and VLAN information for my lab environment. The principal framework for the script was taken from the deployment guide. Let's start by viewing the adapters that we're going to be using. Using the command getNet adapter, we have a list of QLogic adapters here. We're going to be using the ones in slot 4 listed for port 1 and port 2 off of those slots. And let's go ahead and run the script. So simply using the name deployment underscore script, I'm going to go ahead and kick that off. We're seeing the progress. This takes less than a minute to run. And we're almost finished. And there it is, we're done. So at this point, let's take a look, confirm that we see the objects we wanted to create here. Here is our set team, S2D switch. And as you recall, we were also creating three network adapters. So let's rerun that command, getNetAdapter. And sure enough, we're seeing the adapter for our management network the Ethernet, and we're seeing the two virtual adapters for our storage network, storage one and storage two. Now, as a little bonus, I'm going to show you how we can remove our created objects here, our virtual switch. Now we have to define the name of the virtual switch we created. And I agree to all there. Just want to demonstrate how simple it is to reverse this process. So once again, let's take a look. And at this point, we shouldn't see the virtual switch, and we don't. And let's see if those virtual adapters are also gone. And yes, they are. We're back to where we began as far as our adapters are concerned. Okay, that concludes our video on configuring QLogic network adapters for a Dell hyperconverged infrastructure deployment. Thank you for watching.